Landing an aircraft on the deck of a carrier is a demanding task. The aircraft must be precisely controlled to a relatively small area of the carrier deck, despite not only the wind disturbances caused by the ship airwake, but also the large motion of the touchdown point. It is important to keep the proper 3.5 degrees glide path to clear the deck at the safe height. For that reason, the pilot stays totally focused upon the details of landing aboard the ship safely and staying aligned with the center line of the angled flight deck as the ship moves constantly to the right, flying exactly the right approach speed and, most importantly, controlling the decreasing altitude to stay exactly on the right glide slope. From the beginning of the existence of aircraft carriers, one of the most important visual aids for pilots in maintaining the correct glide path was the assistance of landing signal officer. But from the early 1950s, carriers evolved from original straight deck configuration into the angled flight deck, and the new jet aircraft got faster with slower throttle response. So it quickly became apparent that relying only on batsman signals was not enough, and another system was needed to give a real-time information about the airplane's position in relation to the ideal glide path. The first system to meet these expectations was the landing mirror sight invented by the Brits, and more precisely by Admiral Nicholas Goddard. Goddard developed his idea with the aid of his secretary and her makeup pocket mirror. He asked her to draw a horizontal line with her lipstick across the mirror and place it on a table. He then rigged a torch with a pencil beam at the end of the table and shining directly at the mirror. Then he asked the secretary to walk towards the table whilst keeping the beam spot on the mirror on a lipstick line. As she did so, she progressively had to stoop, eventually coming to a halt with her chin touching the desk always at the same spot. Goddard reasoned that the same would be true for a tail hook. And that is how the mirror landing aid was born. Here's how it worked. The most important part of the system was a gyroscopically controlled concave mirror made of cast aluminum on the port side of the flight deck. On either side of the mirror was a line of 14 green-colored high-intensity datum lights, also facing the aircraft. There was a light source located 160 feet in front of the mirror. The source consisted of 4 orange lights, projecting a strong beam towards the mirror and creating the so-called ball, which was reflected to the pilot of the approaching aircraft. The position of the ball compared to the datum lights indicated the aircraft's position in relation to the desired glide path. If the ball was above the datum, the plane was too high. Below the datum, the plane was too low. And between the datum, the plane was on the correct glide path. The gyro stabilization compensated for much of the movement of the flight deck due to the sea, giving a constant glide path. If the aircraft deviated too much either high or low and the light went off the mirror, the watching LSO pressed the wave-off button to activate these red lamps located on either side of the assembly. The lamps would start flashing, signaling the pilot to abort the approach. In order to properly calibrate the correct flight path angle, there was a pole with a mirror on it that was 13 feet high. The pole was placed at a designated spot and one of the service personnel would stand a certain distance down the deck and look up into the mirror on the pole. If he could see the ball, then the mirror was adjusted correctly. After the initial tests, the design turned out to be a success, and one of the first ships on which it was installed was an Australian aircraft carrier HMAS Melbourne. The first deck trials in US Navy ship were held in September 1955 in USS Bennington, which had just been converted to an angled deck carrier. The pilots of Air Development Squadron VX-3, who conducted the trials, liked the new system because it gave them immediate knowledge of their vertical position in the groove, whether they were high or low. The message report cited that the system was successful beyond expectation. The British called the mirror's reflection the blob of light, but someone in VX-3 dubbed it the meatball, a World War II slang for the Japanese Hinomaru emblem, which the light resembled, and later this was shortened to the ball. When an aircraft is on approach in a groove, the LSO will ask the pilot to call the ball, meaning, tell me when you see the light. Answering in the affirmative, the pilot will then fly the ball, so to speak, onto the flight deck. Following the transition to the mirror-guided approach, the LSO role was initially downgraded to more of an administrative one in the belief that the pilot no longer needed his guidance. But it was soon established that the LSO could detect a trend quicker than the pilot and moreover had a better sense of deck motion, which affected the validity of the mirror display even though it was gyro-stabilized. As a result, the LSO was again established as the controlling authority for the approach. But the optical landing system did not disappear. It evolved into a new form, Fresnel Lens Optical Landing System, which will be covered in the next video. That's it for today. If you like this type of presentation and would like to see more, please support this channel by leaving like and comment, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you next time.